Hey, Michelle Glass here. We are looking today at the femur. This is the longest of our long bones. This is, of course, the bone of our thigh. So the thigh is extending from the hip to the knee. So we're looking here at our proximal end. This is the ball that fits into the ball and socket joint of the hip. So the femoral head is going to fit into that acetabulum of the coxal bone. Notice it has a very long neck, which is one way for you to pick it out differently from the humerus. You are actually looking here at the front of the bone. So notice here how it's relatively smooth. If we look at the back of the bone, we can see large projections. You have a raised line on the back, on the shaft. You have your condyles really jutting out to the back. So all of that needs to go down. This is, of course, proximal and medial. This is distal. So you are looking here at a left femur. Now going back to the femoral head, if you look at the medial view, you have a depression here called the fovea capitis. We've already called this round ball the head and the neck. Looking at the back of the bone, we have these two large projections for muscle and ligament attachment. The bigger one is called the greater trochanter, and then the smaller one is called the lesser trochanter. If you're looking at the front of the bone, on some of our models in the lab, you can find what's called the intertrochanteric line. It's this raised line here between the greater and the lesser trochanter, and it's on the front side. Some models, that's hard to find. It's not really represented. We talked about if you feel your hand on the shaft of the femur, that on the back of that shaft, you have a raised line. That raised line there is called the linea aspera. Looking at the distal end, you're going to see your condyles. You're going to have a medial condyle, which is in line with the femoral head. And then up above, you're going to have a medial epicondyle. And so this is going to be the lateral condyle and the lateral epicondyle. And then in between, visible on both sides, you have the intercondylar fossa. And that's your femur.